managed to land the axle. A few prayers being offered by Tonya Harding for her technical program, the competition at the moment being led by the performance of Katarina Witt. Here comes the first of two contrasting American challengers in every way.
On the ice, representing the United States of America, Tonya Harding.
And so, arrived. United States champion. Didn't compete in the World Championship last year. Was fourth in the Olympics of 92. As a combination because she took an extra turn between the two jumps. Spin. Spins to finish, but well, the triple Lutz, the landing wasn't absolutely right, and she fell off it, took an extra pace, and then a double flip. Well, we shall have to see, but that was the best we've seen with Tonya in the past.
But never has she come onto the ice in such circumstances. And the relief now on her face is clear. She's completed her technical program. She covers up the gold skates, but she will know that that was not a potential gold medalist performance. Thought so much about the triple Lutz, which she'd fallen in practice. She was off balance, extra turn before going up for the double toe. And the judges could be generous and take off around 0.2 for the extra turn. I don't think, as you said, Alan, they would have liked the double flip too much either. This is it. Wasn't a running edge when she finished. But the axle, the double axle, was the one jump that she performed without tension. Sneezes, but she looks a very different person now from the lady who came onto the ice. The Americans, of course, have tended to look upon this as a contest between Harding and Kerrigan. It's very much more than that, as Bonnelly and Bayoul and company will tell you. 4-8, the lowest point by elements from Poland and Ukraine, up to 5-3 by Canada. 5-2 from the Czech judge, United States judge giving 5. Judge from the United States, one Margaret Weir, who didn't like Katarina Witt in that area. Up to 5-6, the presentation marks. And 3 5-5s to go along with them. She is, as it were, off and running. And at the moment, in second place, Katarina Witt, with everybody except the judge from the United States, who, dare I say it, surprise, surprise, marked Katarina Witt down. And the United States lady, as a result, is in the lead, which is very difficult to understand. She made no mistakes at all, and Katarina Witt looked a much happier skater out on the ice. There are the people waiting for Tonya Harding to come through to try to grab a quick interview. She's all set to flash. She's being escorted through. And I think we'll probably only give the one interview, her coach coming up, but she has completed her technical program. Talking to Tracy Wilson, we've come to know very well, with her excellent comments on the ice dancing. And Jane Torbell and Christopher Dean with the gold medals now. Christopher, incidentally, sitting just to our right here this evening, alongside his fiancée, Jill Trenery. And the problem for Tracy Wilson is I don't think Tonya Harding has a voice with which to speak. United States officials with the skater. And she's going to need to clear the throat before she talks to anyone. So she disappears to the dressing room. That's the first we've seen of Tonya Harding, and the last for the moment.
Harding there. What did you think of that performance?
I thought, under the circumstances, it was quite remarkable. I think we saw the tension, certainly, on her face before she skated. As Barry said, they haven't seen her do a complete run-through. I thought at one point in the middle she was looking quite tired, but did produce the goods, and even though the combination did have the turn in between, we saw her having trouble with that in the practice, and she actually went. I was still willing her, you know, don't go for something easier, which you know you can do. You know, you came up with an agenda, go for it, and she did.
Although it's worked for Witt, hasn't it? Because she didn't went, you know, she went for an easier combination, she the one she can do.
But Witt doesn't have the option to do anything harder. You know, Harding is known and got the reputation for pulling out the triple axels and the triple lutzes, and as we saw, even though it didn't really work, it was a huge jump, and she is a powerful performer. So, you know, as she would have thought, anything less than doing what I'm capable of, or at least trying what I know I came here to do. And, you know, that's something you think about with your coach while you're waiting, and I was thrilled that she actually tried it.
That's a big barrier, though, isn't it, now, for Tonya? What's going to be her move now for the rest of the competition?
It's over it, you know. It's getting over that barrier, and now knowing that she's had the chance in front of the audience, she's got away with it, she's still alive and kicking, and she will kick even harder in 2 days' time.
The barrier awaits now for Nancy Kerrigan, doesn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely. The pressure's on, you know, Tonya can sort of relax a little bit, and the other girls know what she's done, they know what Witt has done, and the pressure mounts.
In some ways, though, I mean, for now, she obviously will know the marks, and they were mentioning about this American battle between the two of them. I mean, it has left the door open for her, hasn't it?
Well, yes, I don't know that Nancy or her coaches would ever think that Tonya was the only threat. You know,
but it's a personal battle.
It's a personal battle that's been created by people other than themselves. I don't know that you would ever go into a competition saying, I've got to beat so-and-so, when someone else can come along and beat both of you. It doesn't work that way. Mm. And I think the most important thing for Nancy to do now is know what Witt has done, know what Harding has done, and she is one of six girls left who can beat them.
It did surprise me ahead of this event that the judges were instructed to put any thought of what's gone on in advance of this competition out of their minds, as if there was a remote possibility that it might affect the scoring.
Well, I have to sit here as an ex competitor and a skater and say that we hope, you know, judging is judged on its merit at the time, and we know over the past few days that there are people who sort of doubt that already.
Let's hope that is the case, and that remains the case. Robin, thanks again later to see Nancy Kerrigan, I know. Let's just move on to another big woman.